In today's video, I'm going to show you the different types of armor plates, what they do, and the best armor loadout in Ready or Not. I hope you enjoy. So as you all know, July of this year, Ready or Not released an update, their biggest update yet, which included different types of armor plates, as well as different types of armor. But before we start doing that here, the question that you want to ask yourself is, would you prefer having more speed or more protection? That's basically what this comes down to. With the anti-stab vest, pretty self-explanatory, it just helps you protect against knives, but this does allow you to carry more equipment. This is really good if you want to be in the back throwing flashbangs at your enemies, but I would never personally take this. As you can see, it has 15 slots. The next one is a light armor. It's 13 slots and it offers some protection. And what I always carry myself is the heavy armor. This offers the most protection and you can carry the most plates with this. Now that we've spoken about the different types of vests that you can take into a mission, let's look at the armor materials. The first choice is Kevlar. This is the lightest of them all, but it offers the least amount of protection. It's only really good against pistol maps. Then the second choice is steel. Steel is very heavy, but it also offers the most amount of protection. It does also stun you the longest when you do get shot. With ceramic, ceramic is kind of in between the two. It's light, it offers protection, but it does break after a couple shots. Now that we looked at the different armor materials, let's look at the coverages. Heavy armor and light armor have the same three first choices. Only heavy armor offers front, back, and sides. My personal opinion is that you only ever need to run front only for the simple fact that if you clear rooms properly and make sure that there's no suspects left unchecked, you won't ever get shot in the back. Here are the different armors as well as how they affect your walking speed. This includes light armor as well as heavy armor. As you can see, there's no real difference here between steel, Kevlar, or ceramic. That's why it's always best to run steel, heavy armor for the best protection. After talking about the different types of protective vests, armor materials, as well as the different coverages that you can choose, we're going to be using an unmodified M4A1 to do damage tests on all these armor plates. So after extensive testing with the unmodified M4A1, it does seem like in reality steel is the best choice to take, as you can take up to 5 hits before perishing. Also, the fact is, taking heavy armor just simply means that you have more armor around you, and in reality, having more protection over 2 equipment slots, this proves that heavy armor is the best choice to take with steel. Hey, you better like, comment, and subscribe. Also hit that notification bell, otherwise Bob here is gonna get it.